For pregnancy loss and miscarriages.
Yeah, this is a really difficult thing that a lot of women experience, myself included. I have had multiple miscarriages, and for grieving parents, this is a pain that really doesn't stop, and it's something that is not talked about enough. So joining us now to bring attention to the issue is fertility consultant and coach Abby Feeder. Abby, thank you so much for joining us to talk about this. Again, just so important to have this conversation. So thank you.
Thank you for having me. Thank you for bringing light to this topic. And thank you for opening your own story to your public, because that's really the best way we learn about what the right thing to do is and the right thing to say is and how common this problem is.
Yeah, that so many of us have gone through this. And we know a lot of women still struggle with sharing their stories when they experience a miscarriage. So talk about that and just how common it is.
Yeah, so the number right now is about 1 in 4 women will experience miscarriage or have experienced miscarriage. And let me just say, I hate the term miscarriage. We got to work on that. It's just such a loaded word. It brings a lot of shame and a lot of negativity to it. Obviously, it is a negative experience, but, you know, 1 in 4 women, that's from reported pregnancy loss. Many women don't know that they're pregnant when they experience the loss. So really, that number might be more. So if you think about that, it's like you walk into a restaurant and you see 4 girlfriends at a table, one of them had a miscarriage. That's a really big number. Why aren't we talking about it more?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, for sure. You know, there's a lot of misconceptions surrounding pregnancy loss, from the physical to the emotional toll that women feel, but men feel them as well. The partners, you know, it's hard for the guys as well.
It's a really great point. It's very hard because the man obviously isn't experiencing a physical reaction. So literally from the physical belly to the hormone change that happens when a miscarriage happens, your hormones change very rapidly. There's a lot of up and down and a lot of roller coaster. It doesn't mean the man's not feeling the loss or feeling the pain. And it's really important to honor the hurt in the man. A lot of times partners, husbands, don't know the right thing to do or say. They don't know how to feel about it. Are they feeling not sad enough? Too sad? How long should they let the hurt go on? Those are all questions that are really important to talk about with your partner and make sure that you're supporting each other through the loss.
And
I just want to say also about the misconceptions. I experienced several miscarriages. And one thing that I thought before it happened was that it was just a very quick process. All of a sudden, you would be pregnant, and then all of a sudden something physical would happen and you would not be pregnant. And that's really not how it is at all. It can take weeks for the miscarriage to clear your body. And that emotional toll of waiting to be unpregnant so that you can plan and move on to the next thing can be really the most torturous piece of the whole process.
That is a really great point. Yeah, day after day, you are reminded of that loss because it takes such a long time. So that's an excellent point that you bring up. And what can women do when they experience pregnancy loss? What resources are out there?
That's a great question. So I'm a wonderful resource, and there are lots of other fertility and miscarriage doulas out there and people who've been through it who really truly understand what you're going through. From a very spiritual level, you have to feel it to heal it. So I say, don't rush out of your grief. Let yourself feel whatever you need to feel. It is a huge loss. You might not be able to physically see the loss. That doesn't mean it didn't happen or it doesn't exist. And then from a very practical level, I really believe in salt's cure. I find salt very healing. So I always say sweat, ocean, Epsom salt, tears, all ways that salt can be involved in healing in all 4. So it's like, go for a walk, get your sweating on, go for a good cry, put your feet in the ocean, take a nice Epsom bath. Those are ways from a very practical level you can heal through the trauma.
Yeah.
All right, Abby, this is all so helpful. Thank you so much. And just really quickly, how can people reach out to you for your guidance?
Sure, I'm at InCircle Fertility, InCircle, Fertility, all 1 word. I'm on Instagram. You can email me hello@InCircleFertility, or my website is InCircleFertility.com.
All right, Abby Feeder, thank you so, so much for having this important conversation with us this morning.
Appreciate you.
All right. All right, moving on now. This